竞选承诺。
Donald J. Trump is calling for a total and complete shutdown of Muslims entering the United States until our country's representatives can figure out what the hell is going on。
在川普入主白宫17个月后，演变成对美国宪法基本价值的最大冲击。
Today, the Supreme Court ruled 5-4 that President Trump's travel restrictions on people from 7 countries will stay in effect.
The major victory for President Trump.
Within minutes of the ruling, President Trump was tweeting victory.
Wow.
A tremendous success, a tremendous victory for the American people and for our Constitution.
Writing for a conservative majority, Chief Justice John Roberts said the ban is squarely within the scope of presidential authority.
Today, the Supreme Court ruled on actually the third version of the travel ban.
His controversial executive order, one that bars 134 million people.
The travel ban the president signed just days after taking office didn't mention Muslims, but targeted only Muslim countries.
Protests and demonstrations at airports across the country.
Lawsuits were filed and the ban was blocked. In March 2017, a second travel ban was unveiled and blocked again. The Trump administration released the most recent version of the travel ban in September of last year. The state of Hawaii, as lead plaintiff, argued against the ban, saying one, that the president had overstepped his authority, and two, that the order violates the Constitution's Establishment Clause, which bars the government from favoring one religion over another.
This one, very different in crucial ways. It was issued after a worldwide review of security procedures in different countries. It offers case-by-case waivers for some individuals, people with long business relationships or close American family members, for instance. And it barred some individuals from non-Muslim countries, North Korea and Venezuela.
这一次最高法院中的保守派胜出。
And they said that this really is not a Muslim ban. In fact, most of the countries with very large Muslim populations are not part of the ban.
Donald Trump!
Shame!
Supreme Court!
Shame!
Justice Sonia Sotomayor wrote, the majority here completely sets aside the president's charged statements about Muslims as irrelevant. That holding erodes the foundational principles of religious tolerance that the court elsewhere has so emphatically protected. And it tells members of minority religions in our country that they are outsiders, not full members of the political community.
This morning, when I heard about this, I was heartbroken.
原以为这会是对美国民主价值最大的打击。谁知道在不到24小时之内，另一个爆炸性的新闻令美国自由派迎来最黑暗的一天。
Supreme Court Justice Anthony Kennedy is retiring.
We as a people are bound together.
81岁甘乃迪大法官在联邦司法体系任职43年，其中30年在最高法院。他的退休将于7月31日生效。
He spent 30 years on the court and has long been a swing vote that decided key cases. Now his retirement could trigger an all-out election year war over a successor.
这项消息对于正值其中选举的共和党无疑是一大利多。
Now, Justice Kennedy's retirement gives the president a chance to nominate another conservative, having already placed Neil Gorsuch on the bench. Minority Leader Chuck Schumer demanded that any nomination wait until after the midterm elections in November. Majority Leader Mitch McConnell today promised speedy action.
英国金融时报直接以为未来的最高法院展开的一场史诗般的政治斗争来形容保守与自由派。在甘乃迪宣布退休24小时之内，狠砸数百万美元狂打广告战的现象。
A chance to appoint another great justice. President Trump's list includes the best of the best, and with your help, America will get another star on the Supreme Court.
The death of former Justice Antonin Scalia gave the winner of the 2016 election a chance to pick one justice right away.Donald Trump cited that power on the campaign trail to reassure anxious Christian conservatives.
川普信守承诺，上任还不到2个礼拜，就提名保守派血统纯正的戈萨奇。而甘乃迪法官的退休，更是给了川普实践另一个竞选承诺的机会。
So here's what's going to happen. I'm pro-life. The judges will be pro-life.
因为多数时候和保守派站在一块的甘乃迪法官在同志权利、堕胎、平权行动和死刑议题上经常倒向自由派的裁决。
Kennedy also shifted sides at times. In 1992, he voted to uphold the right to abortion. He backed affirmative action in a case from Texas in 2016.
He refused to go along with a decision that would have wiped out Roe v. Wade.
The cases swing, I don't.
One thing that is so important about Justice Kennedy's retirement is that it is the first time in about 25 years that a new justice could radically change the direction of the Supreme Court. The last time that happened was when Clarence Thomas replaced Thurgood Marshall. Thomas, a strong conservative, Marshall, one of the most liberal members of the court. All the justices who have been appointed since Clarence Thomas have replaced justices who are pretty much of the same ideological leanings.
Justice Kennedy's greatest judicial legacy was his championship of gay rights.
They ask for equal dignity in the eyes of the law, and the Constitution grants them that right.
His decision about the constitutional right for same-sex couples to marry.
Anthony Kennedy was a federal appeals judge when President Reagan nominated him to the Supreme Court in 1987. He sailed through the Senate by a vote of 97-0 and was sworn in on February 18, 1988.
Well, the Constitution doesn't belong to a bunch of judges. It doesn't belong to a bunch of lawyers. It's yours. It's yours.
Justice Kennedy was a moderate conservative, voted more often with the court's conservative wing, was the author of Citizens United, which amplified the role of money in politics, cast a vote with the five-justice majority in Bush v. Gore in 2000, which handed the presidency to President George W. Bush.
And just yesterday, he sided with the majority, upholding President Trump's travel ban.
We're going to pick ourselves one great United States Supreme Court justice. He decided to do this during our term. And I think that showed confidence in us.
甘乃迪的退休几乎笃定将使保守派在最高法院确立5-4的优势。然而自由派的噩梦还不止于此。四位自由派大法官之中，金兹堡已年届85岁高龄，布瑞尔也将在8月满80岁。相较之下，最年长的保守派大法官汤马斯才刚过70岁生日。在川普剩下任期内，最高法院的保守派甚至有希望扩大差距到7-2。时代杂志说了，整个最高法院已是川普的囊中物。